First was an image of a man alone and contorted in pain. I met a medium recently, found myself having breakfast with him. And this turned out to be a really interesting experience. I'm not religious, but I'm open to all kinds of possibilities. After all, isn't over 80% of the universe made up of dark matter or something like that? Something we can't detect accounts for a whole lot of everything. So I was talking to this medium, let's call him Paul, because that was his name. And the conversation moved through this and that, astrology and fire signs and all kinds of stuff. And I told him that I mentioned at one point that me and my daughter, we share the same birth date. And he said, you're air people. Air people. I love that. Air people. And he said that air people can be either, say, a gentle breeze or a real force of nature. And I laughed. And I said, that's me and my daughter, all right. And then we got on to writing and journaling and morning pages and all that kind of thing. And I mentioned that I do gratitude journaling last thing at night before I go to sleep. And also mentioned that, you know, sometimes I ask my dad for, you know, advice or guidance and that kind of thing. And he died a few years ago. I don't know if this is something I believe, you know, that he's out there somewhere. But, you know, all that dark matter, there's only so much energy in the universe. Who knows? Anyway, he made a suggestion. He said, say this to yourself. Show me a life I've lived before. And then you meditate for 5 minutes. When you open your eyes, you write whatever's in your mind. And I've got to tell you, the result was pretty dramatic. So what I'm going to do now is just read this from the notebook. I didn't want to dictate what you see in your mind's eye when I share this with you. So I'm just going to read this out. So here we go. Here's the notebook. So the first thing, this notebook. The first was an image of a man alone and contorted in pain. It was like a photograph, a still image. He had dark hair. I don't know if that was me. Could be. And then I'm with a young woman. She's in her late 20s, maybe. And we're in a barn. There's lots of hay. She's wearing a blue and white check pinafore dress. We're scared. We're hiding. Someone's coming. In my mind, I'm feeling like soldiers. We don't want to be separated, but I have to go. I feel like we've had some kind of romantic relationship. She steers me towards the door. She's glancing back. Someone's coming. You must go, she says. Now, I'm wearing a green uniform. I feel like it's like World War II Army or something like that. What have I put there? I also got an image of a church, or it might have been a castle, a stained glass window, a steam train hooted. And I also got an image of a harbour, like there was no people, but it was a small working port, like a French fishing village, something like that. Dark grey buildings made of big blocks of stone and cold grey water, still water. There was a tension in the air. And that was what I got after asking myself, show me a life I lived before. It was fragments, but they were really quite vivid. And there was a genuine emotional charge. It was really quite distinct. So what was this? Was it some kind of dream? Something I made up? Was it images from a life I've lived before? I have no idea. What do you think about all this? If you try it, let me know, because I'm really interested in what you see, if anything. I think the technique is very similar to morning pages. You don't think, you just see what comes out. If you give it a try, let me know in the comments, okay? I'd love to know. Let me know what you think about mediums and the afterlife or whatever. I'm intrigued by all that, the universe and all this dark matter. If you've enjoyed this video, clicking the like button helps other people find it too, and do consider subscribing for more videos on similar subjects coming soon.